Pittsburgh extended Hollywood star David Niven a resounding welcome today as he arrived in an antique balloon to tour the many agencies of the United Fund of Allegheny County and to get a first-hand report of their outstanding services to the people of the community.
Following the descent of the lighter-than aircraft, Niven was taken on a grand tour of the city in a caravan of antique automobiles to visit the various agencies of the United Fund of Allegheny County. History repeated itself today, at least movie-making history, when motion picture star David Niven came to Pittsburgh to reenact his role as Phileas Fogg in Around the World in 80 Days. The celebrated actor coming to town to visit the health, welfare, and character-building agencies of the United Fund of Allegheny County entered our city in a most peculiar manner. He descended on the Golden Triangle this morning in an old-fashioned balloon. He began a tour of the city at the Point. He made his way through the downtown streets in a motorcade of antique automobiles. And the people of the community greeted the famous star with a tremendous ovation, waving his beaver hat to the thousands of astonished bystanders. Niven was impeccably dressed in a formal morning attire as he made his grand entrance. The caravan made its first stop on Smithfield Street, where David Niven, or rather, Phileas Fogg, saw the efficient operation of the Red Cross, a United Fund agency. Then, up the Boulevard of the Allies to the Salvation Army. Downtown YMCA for a better picture of the facilities of the UF agencies. And so on through many of the agencies throughout Allegheny County. The Goodwill Industries at 2801 Liberty Avenue. The Multiple Sclerosis Mobile Unit. Traveler's Aid at the Pennsylvania Railroad Station. And the Anna B. Heldman Center in the Hill District, just to name a few. Yes, Phileas Fogg repeated motion picture history in Pittsburgh today, while history was being made by the United Fund.
Now, I know that you kids at school have to study the three R's, reading, writing, arithmetic. But we actors have to study the two H's, hair and hats. Now, with the right hair combined with the right hat, we can play practically anything. For instance, I can be one of the Three Musketeers. With the same hair and a different hat, I could be an Austrian Archduke. Now, removing the hair, changing the hat, taking off the cloak, and substituting an umbrella for my sword, I could be Mr. Phileas Fogg of Around the World in 80 Days. We have precisely 3 minutes and 32 seconds to present ourselves at the Goodwill Industries. Passepartout, arrange for the tickets.
Oh, Mr. Niven, there's a little patient of mine who has begged to talk to Phileas Fogg. It seems she has a question.
Which one is she?
She's ill and she's still confined to our home, but it's not very far away. A visit from you would do her a lot of good.
Fine, let's go.
Thank you. And now, children, if you will excuse Mr. Niven, we have another stop to make.
Goodbye, kids.
Goodbye, Mr. Niven. Come in.
Here, Peter.
Ah, I have the honor, I believe, of addressing Catherine.
Oh, I know. You're Phileas Fogg of Around the World in 80 Days.
Did you see the picture?
No, I'm reading the book. I have it here, see?
Oh, yes, I see.
It's my favorite story, Mr. Fogg. Oh, I was so afraid something would happen when you were up in that balloon. Weren't you worried? And when you rescued the princess from those awful natives, oh, I was so scared.
As a matter of fact, I was, too.
Mr. Fogg?
Mm-hmm?
Ever since the first time I read about your trip, I always wondered what happened after you got back to London.
Well, let me see. I married the princess, of course.
Is that all? Didn't you do anything exciting?
Well, it wasn't exactly dull, but I see what you mean. Oh, I became restless rather quickly, and pretty soon I was off again on my travels.
I knew it. You started going around the world again, and you never, never stopped.
That's right. That's exactly what happened.
Why'd you come here? You won't have many adventures around here.
But I'm having one. I think this is the most exciting adventure of all.
Really? Here?
Catherine, when you've been around the world as much as I have, I've seen wonderful things, and I've seen beautiful things. For instance, I saw things most people only see in pictures. In India, the great Taj Mahal. A building so rich and beautiful you can't believe it. But in the same country were men and women and children dying for the want of something to eat. Misery and human suffering were an accepted condition of life. It's that way in all too many parts of the world. Outwardly, strength, elegance, and wealth. But underneath, poverty, sickness, starvation, and worst of all, indifference to the despair of people who are suffering under these afflictions. In some places on the earth, the things you see seem to indicate prosperity and progress and goodwill among men, when in fact the people die in the streets to be free of dictatorship and oppression and regimentation. When you've traveled as much as I have, and when you've seen what happens when people become indifferent to the hopes and the needs of their neighbors, then this county of yours, this wonderful free American county, becomes a magic place and an enchanted land. It's like something out of a fairy tale. Of course, when you live here, it's rather difficult to look upon it like that. I wish you could have been with me when I arrived. I saw your county as the world sees it. A living, working, growing example of what men can accomplish when they live in freedom, when they work together toward common goals, where opportunity is open to everyone, and where no one is neglected or forgotten. The world is well aware of the strength of this county. Its tremendous booming industry. Its vital, vigorous commerce. Its driving, determined civic spirit. But these are only the signs and the symbols of greatness. Behind them, there must be, and there is, another kind of greatness that lies deep in the nature of the people themselves. And today, I saw that side of your county. And that's what makes this the most exciting adventure of all. Of course, basically, the people here are exactly the same as people anywhere else in the world. They get sick, they have their worries and their troubles and their sorrows, even their disasters. But when they're faced with a situation where they can no longer go on alone, where they really need help, the wonderful thing is, that help's always there. For example, I visited the Goodwill Industries. The people here, many of them once led happy, productive lives. Then disaster struck, in one form or another. A stroke, diabetes, an amputation, polio, arthritis, name it, and they know it. Suddenly the old life ended and a new and terrifyingly unknown one took its place. Here at Goodwill Industries, they meet this new life head on. They learn to overcome their new disabilities and to become useful again. It takes money, lots of it, to provide the kind of equipment and training it takes to turn despair into hope and a new life. But here it is. Wherever you look in this county, there are United Fund dollars at work, restoring self-respect, replacing chaos with courage, helping the helpless, giving community service as well as never-ending research and education, not only for multiple sclerosis, but for all sorts of crippling and disabling diseases, like muscular dystrophy, heart, cancer, cystic fibrosis, arthritis, and rheumatism, on down the list.
The United Fund serves people who need help from the Salvation Army, or help in a time of need at the Traveler's Aid Desk. A place to turn in the face of disaster. Place. A visitor and a friend when there are no friends. Someone to take over when mommies and daddies are not available. Someone to counsel and help when guidance is needed in finding a job or a vocation. A place for boys to grow in responsibility and citizenship during the critical adolescent years. A place in the community for supervised, organized recreation, which is available to every member of the family. So you see, Catherine, when you find a place where people share their good fortune with their neighbors, where they work for and give to a wonderful cause like the United Fund, not because they have to, but just because they want to. When you find a place like that, well, to an old world traveler like me, that's the most wonderful adventure of all. Now, I have precisely 1 minute and 30 seconds to be on my way.
Where are you going from here, Mr. Fogg?
Dependent as I am upon the wind, I don't really know.
When you go to those countries where there's no United Fund to take care of kids like me, you tell them how it is here in our Allegheny County, will you?
I will, Catherine. I will.
Mr. Niven, the cars are ready.
The cars? Mr. Niven? He said you were really Phileas Fogg. And he said...
Oh, but Catherine, you said...
Goodbye, Catherine.
You are Phileas Fogg. And it was a wonderful adventure, even if it did happen right here at home.
The most wonderful things always happen at home, Catherine. Provided you have the faith to make them happen. Goodbye.
Goodbye.